emerged that I think will be interesting for us to talk about during the course of the broadcast as well.
Well, one advantage that Monmouth has in this matchup as we're underway is at the faceoff X, as sophomore Matt Soutar again wins the faceoff.
The energy of being here at Kessler Stadium, a spot that Monmouth has played well in this year. They had win over Manhattan, St. Bonaventure earlier, Quinnipiac, Detroit Mercy, and then the game against Siena. So they haven't lost here at home this season. And if you can, it takes a while to get going, right? And I think, again, to the point that we talked about on the open, you can make a really good parallel between Monmouth, who struggled in their first year. Takes a while to get things going, get it up and, you know, crank it the way that you want. But now in the third year,
just his fifth goal of the season. It's the senior's fifth career man-up goal as well to give Monmouth the 2-1 lead. And then it's Monmouth Scooter Whiteside to track down the face-off. Monmouth the lead with possession. A big shot. Career high six goals in that game, and when Cade Stratton scores for Monmouth, it's a good thing. Monmouth has won six
in their third year. That was a special, special goal.
You know how a big dunk can jazz up a basketball team on a run? A goal like the Dobson play on the interception. Can Monmouth score here late? Another save by Dobson that'll be batted away by
the coaching staff that knows how to do it. Not only do they know how to do it, they know how to do it within the league that they're already in, so you can build, you know, the recruiting scene, you know what you can offer, and clearly St. Bonaventure did. I would imagine that each was a major talking point for the opposition and what they do defensively going into this game.
Rose has been good since day one stepping foot on campus in Olean, and Stratton, now a junior, has become one of Monmouth's really relied upon attack. Soutar is just having a dominant day at faceoff. He's won 8 of 11. That shot head down to drive, but that time they keep the head up. Nice assist by Connor McCray. And Monmouth is now a man up and leads 6-4. Penalty was called again on Andrew Hersey. His second penalty, the 1 minute for slash. Third year head man, not very happy as Monmouth almost gets a shot at 10.
First year, it's been a calling card for Brian Fisher. Start with defense, make it hard for the other teams to score, and we'll work on the rest of it as we push forward.
Now 11 of 14. That's been probably the biggest adjustment we've seen in this game. You know, St. Bonaventure really packs it in defensively, and we've seen Monmouth, who wins another faceoff here with Dylan Smart, move the ball, better possession
for the bodies.
Second goal of the game for Jake Rosa. We were just mentioning how with the two players each for Monmouth and St. Bonaventure getting sent off, there was so much room, and then Bonnie's forcing a huge Monmouth turnover in the semifinals. Back. And to Matt's point again, Soutar has been dominant at the faceoff X.
For me, has been Mama's most consistent attacker all during the course of the afternoon.
Sophomore from nearby Middletown, New Jersey. And this game became the third Monmouth player on the season with double-digit goals. And again, hats off to the season, Randy Mearns and St. Bonaventure.